Hachette Audio presents How to American, an immigrant's guide to disappointing your parents. Written and read by me, Jimmy O'Yang, with a foreword from Mike Judge. Includes a bonus PDF of photos. Cool photos. Hey guys, thanks for buying this book. According to the audio engineer here, I'm the first Asian comedian that's ever recorded a book. Or I don't know, first Asian comedian I ever worked with. But this is fun. Thank you. Again, I don't know if you're Asian or not, but either way, you're helping the cause of putting more Asian entertainers on the map. And this story is for everyone, man. And some of this, I'm gonna improvise like I am doing right now. This is not in the book. So you can only hear this if you're on the audiobook. So if your friend has a book, tell them to buy the audiobook too. Double the paycheck for me. That'd be great. Now, a lot of you guys are wondering, oh my God, this is Jing Yang from Silicon Valley, but he talks like a normal person. Of course I do. It's called acting, you people. But some of this I'll read in character. And some of these I'll read in other people's character. So hopefully you guys will enjoy this journey with me as I read to you my own life. Man. This is the most narcissistic thing I've ever done, but hopefully you enjoy it as much as I do.
Foreword, written by Mike Judge. When we first cast Jimmy O. Yang in Silicon Valley, I didn't know anything about him. I just had a good feeling about him based on his audition. I had no idea that the accent he was doing was not the way he normally spoke, and that his persona was very different from that of the character he was playing in our show, Jin Yang. I also didn't know that he had graduated with a degree in economics from UCSD, the same school I graduated from many years earlier, or that he graduated in 2009, the year that I gave the commencement speech, and that he had attended it, and apparently had been somewhat inspired to go into comedy by what I said. I found all this out after we had been working on set for a couple days. Jimmy and I hit it off right away and became fast friends. As you'll notice when you read this book, he's a funny guy with an interesting and unique perspective on things in this country. You don't often hear the stories about Chinese immigrants. At least it seems that way to me. I think maybe it's because we Americans just don't ask. Jimmy and I hung out quite a bit, and I became interested in his story. It's an interesting one. He's had quite a journey. From being a child ping pong star in Hong Kong, to coming to America and becoming a stand-up comedian, achieving his dream of being a strip club DJ, only to discover how sad and depressing that is, to becoming a successful TV and movie actor. Jimmy has really experienced America like few have. When we were shooting the first season of Silicon Valley, we had no idea if the show would become a hit and go on for more seasons, or if it would flop and be quickly forgotten. We were all just working away, trying our best to make it good and hoping it would work. Jimmy always had a great optimism about him, and when we'd talk about the show, it would make my cynical ass believe that maybe it could be a hit. And then it was. And as we went on to do additional seasons, Jimmy's character quickly became a cornerstone of the show. He also became my favorite character to write for around season 3. There's something great and stoic about Jin Yang that Jimmy embodies perfectly. I know that sometimes language barrier jokes can be considered easy by comedy snobs, but Jimmy makes it all work in a really great way. I was already getting a sense that Jin Yang was becoming a favorite character on the show, but it really hit me when we were doing a panel at Comic-Con San Diego in 2016. We were in one of the big rooms with a couple thousand people. I'm bad with crowd numbers, but it was at least that, maybe 3,000 or 4,000. And someone asked if there was going to be more Jin Yang next season. This was followed by thunderous applause, which was followed by even more thunderous applause when I said yes. Jimmy was officially famous. Part of my inspiration for the show Silicon Valley came from back when I was working as an engineer. And at my first engineering job, I had an Iranian friend who worked there too, who said something that always stuck with me. He said that this really is the land of opportunity, but most Americans just don't see it because they're simply too used to it. They don't appreciate it, and they don't take advantage of it as much as people who move here from other countries do. When you come to America from a place like Iran, you get here and you just marvel at all the opportunities and the freedom. Reading this book, you get the sense that Jimmy had that same experience, and he did not waste the opportunity at all. He worked his ass off for everything he has. Jimmy's experience is uniquely American. You just don't hear these kinds of stories from other countries. Okay, somebody slap me. I'm getting too patriotic. Here's something I'll never forget about Jimmy. Before the first season of Silicon Valley had aired, Jimmy and I were sitting at the bar at a restaurant in Santa Monica. Now, when I'm out with him, we are often interrupted by fans who recognize him and want to take selfies. I was asking him about China. He was saying that if you're an ordinary American and you go to China, it's like being a movie star. Everyone stares at you and wants to be around you. He said it's the same if an American goes to Cuba. Then he paused for a second, looked down at his drink, and said, "There's nowhere I can go." Well, Jimmy, now there's nowhere you can't go without being recognized like a star. Welcome to America, Jimmy O. Yang. Mike Judge.
Prologue! I eat the fish. I said this to my roommate in my thick Chinese accent. I know you eat the fish, but when you clean the fish, you can't just leave the fish head and guts and shit in the sink because the whole house smells like a bait station. So you got to put it in the trash, then take the trash out. Do you understand? My big, curly-haired American roommate explained to me, pointing at the leftover fish parts in the sink. I stared at him, confused. And I replied, "Yes, I eat the fish." "Motherfuck!" he howled in complete frustration. The whole crew burst out in laughter. That was my second day on the set of Silicon Valley, an HBO show created by one of my comedy heroes, Mike Judge. It was my big break in Hollywood. My character Jing Yang is a fresh-off-the-boat Chinese immigrant whose struggle with the English language often leads to comical misunderstandings with his buffoonish roommate, Ehrlich Bachman, played by the impeccable T.J. Miller. It felt natural for me to play this character. I was once a fresh-off-the-boat Chinese immigrant myself. I was Jing Yang. When my family immigrated to America from Hong Kong, I was a 13-year-old boy who looked like an 8-year-old girl. I didn't even speak enough English to understand the simplest American slang. On my first day of school in America, a girl came up to me and said, "What's up?" I stared at her, confused. I had never heard this term before. She repeated, "What's up?" I looked up into the sky to check what is up there. There wasn't anything. I looked back down at her and I replied, "I don't know." She finally realized I was either foreign or severely mentally handicapped. So she explained, "What's up means how are you doing?" "Oh, okay. I'm up. Thank you." Then someone in the distance screamed out, "Heads up!" I turned to reply, thinking it was another American greeting. Instead, I was greeted by a weird oblong object flying right at me and hitting me straight in the gut. I later learned that was an American football. This wasn't an episode of Silicon Valley. This was my life. Now, that was a cool prologue, huh? I didn't want to write a prologue, but the publisher said it would look super official, so there you go. I barely know what prologue means. But there will be an epilogue also, because we're professionals here.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.